You know what? I think it's finally been long enough. Julia.
Does this mean we have to start fighting?
No. It's fine. I'll do someone else. But can I just say, I think this whole thing is getting a little bit catty.
Meow.
God damn it, I walked right into that one, didn't I? Welcome to A Tough Act to Follow. I'm Preston, aka the Ploominator, and I will be your pitch-perfect lounge singer here to enhance the tunes that highlight the very best and brightest parts of Hollywood stardom. And before I get started, I just want to make sure that everyone is getting the full experience of the Plumination, so be sure to share, like, and subscribe. And check out my Patreon for even more. Links below. And it has been far too long since I took a fan request for this channel, so I thought it was time to add one into the mix. So, while I will take credit for making the video, I can't take credit for the overall idea. That goes to those of you in the comments, and especially Natalie Howard for suggesting this one. Because Natalie saw what I too now see, that there is a talent we all know from numerous places who just keeps returning to deliver compelling and sensational performances time after time. And the fact that she has cemented her career with iconic roles in decade after decade is a credit to the fact that no matter how hard they try, they cannot duplicate the wealth of star power that is Michelle Pfeiffer. And now we get the chance to explore the merits and talents of an actress who is continuing to show just how good she is at creating complex and interesting characters that break down barriers and redefine what a leading lady can be. From her dynamic range, to her iconic appearance, to her super detailed instincts and layers upon layers of performances, there is no doubt that those of you who suggested are right about one thing. Michelle Pfeiffer is a tough act to follow. Michelle has come back into the spotlight time after time, and there's clearly a reason for that, and I think it starts with her screen presence. She's got such a unique and compelling look about her, and it instantly draws our eye to her. And again, I'm not just talking about attraction, I mean that she has an energy that physically makes her compelling even when she's not speaking.
I want you to meet a friend of mine. Come on. Tony Montana.
Hello.
I need Roberta. Dita.
So, there are five of us. Where are we having dinner?
I thought we'd go to the Babylon Club.
Again?
Again.
You know, Frank, if anyone ever wanted to assassinate you, you wouldn't be too hard to find.
Assassinate me? Who the hell would want to kill me?
But what makes this physicality so great is it's not just about this single idea of the character. Yes, Michelle is making a strong first impact, but there is so much more to her than that one moment. She's got something spectacular about her, and that's that she's not hiding her feelings at all from anyone in the room. She is managing to convey one idea physically, that she's some compelling trophy wife, but at the same time, she shows that she is in no way happy with where her life is. And to manage to do both of these at the same time is incredibly tough, and it shows that she is acting far deeper than she may appear to be at first.
You think you're
God! Come on!
Are you gonna drive him to school in the mornings? Are you even gonna be alive by the time the kid goes to school? You don't even know how to be a husband!
Shut up!
Where are you without having your thoughts hanging around all the time?
Yes, okay.
I have Nick, the pig, as a friend. What kind of life is that?
And then Michelle takes this a step further by not only showing the layers, but then fighting them. She has intentions that conflict with her character's values, and those come together to make her characters far more interesting overall. This then takes what was already established, a charismatic energy that compels audiences to watch her when she's on screen, and dials it up because now she's conflicted. Now she's got an interesting internal struggle, and that makes her even more magnetic because we want to know which way her struggle will take her.
And I'm afraid she's insisting that I give you up. It's beyond my control.
Liar! Liar!
You're quite right, I am a liar. And it's like your fidelity, a fact of life, no more nor less irritating. Certainly beyond my control.
Stop it! Don't keep saying that.
Sorry. Beyond my control.
And then, as with all struggles, there are moments where you see the truth come fully out, and it's not always what you want. And that sense of regret that hits you lives as guilt in the series of what-ifs that people will have to face going forward. Michelle thrives in this land of what-ifs. She's able to show so many thoughts and ideas racing through her head, and it all comes to the surface in a way that we understand her struggle. But beyond that, we can also feel for her because those emotions are still really raw and really true.
I'm most desperately in love. To leave is the last thing in the world I want to do, but I'd rather die than have to live with the guilt.
My dear girl, none of this is any surprise to me. The only thing that might surprise one is how little the world changes.
What should I do? What's your advice?
I remember rightly in such matters, all advice is useless.
I've never been so unhappy.
And all of these internal struggles then lead to action. Michelle's actions are never done simply to do something. There is always a purpose and drive behind her choices, and it makes the characters push the stakes of the story forward because these actions are not just impulses, they are well thought out, they are carefully chosen, and they are deliberately performed, even when it seems entirely impulsive. This decisiveness then manifests into confidence, which again makes Michelle compelling. She pushes this idea of herself into being more capable than anyone else, and it really helps sell even the most absurd of moments. Moments in movies are often beyond the scope of reality anyway, as the stories that these movies tell don't always have both feet firmly on the ground in reality. But to make these moments confident and then human really sells the movie and helps us keep invested in the characters within it, which is what Michelle is doing so well.
Oh, you mean, as in serious, No, had one, didn't work.
What went wrong? Hang on, I think I know. You kept things from her.
No, told her everything.
Huh? And the truth frightened her?
Well, there are two truths. You know, and she had trouble reconciling them because I had trouble reconciling them.
Yeah.
So you take all these ideas, and then you have to go beyond the page. You have to show the actual motivations behind everything, because people are not just motivated by simple things and singular moments, and you have to showcase the details to really help flesh out the characters fully. Michelle lives for the small details of her characters. From her movements to her body language and so much more, you can see these details just coming out in every little thing that she does.
I've never worked in a restaurant before, but I'm a hard worker and I learn real fast.
Good. Let's try this uniform on, and then we'll see how things look.
Okay.
You can change in here.
Okay.
For privacy. Furthermore, I'll lock the door.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
But you take that then a step further and add very subtle motivations into these details. Michelle has tension, relaxation, choices of movement, vocal delivery, and so much more because she has something either in her past or present that is causing her to express those aspects of herself. And all of that comes together to make a more complete character, so that even in the more absurd moments, there is still a real person living within them.
Well, you know, I wanted to see you.
Get out.
You know, you really scared me the day of the funeral. You don't realize the effect you have on a woman. You know, you're a very powerful guy, Tony.
Don't bullshit me, Angela.
Well, you don't get it, do you? Well, I didn't expect you to.
Mm-hmm. And then everything comes completely together because Michelle doesn't let herself get stuck into a box. She has played a wild series of diverse roles, and all of it allows her to propel her career forward beyond a small pool of roles that other women in Hollywood can get boxed into. Michelle has taken chances to play roles that push her comfort zone, and in the end, it's paid off by helping her make her career longer and more diverse than many other people like her.
A lot of shoes, a lot of rice, the groom. Nervous, he answers twice. It's really killing that he's so willing to make whoopee.
But at the end of the day, the truth is that she's going to continue to keep showing up in movie after movie because there's a clear love for what she does. If there wasn't, the roles that she takes wouldn't be so aggressively committed to, and she wouldn't work so hard to continue to reinvent the way that audiences see her. She's good because she wants to be, and she takes the process seriously from start to finish.
I was there. I saw it in your face. You're full of shit. You're a fake.
Every time you walk into some shitty daiquiri hut, you're selling yourself on the cheap. I know all about that. I'd find myself at the end of the night with some creep and tell myself it didn't matter. And you kid yourself that you got this empty place inside where you can put it all. But you do it long enough and all you are is empty.
And I know that may seem like a really simple idea, but it's true. Michelle's power comes from her commitment to her craft and how she uses her talents to bring those ideas back into her roles over and over again, making her a real talent who is just continuing to build on top of an already brilliant career. So why do we like Michelle Pfeiffer? One, Michelle holds our attention. While her overall presence initially compels us, it's Michelle's ability to create a character with clear, motivated, and well-thought-out physicality which helps continue to hold our attention no matter how long she's on screen. Two, Michelle creates internal conflict. While external conflict can drive the plot of a story to compelling places, Michelle knows that having internal struggles will help motivate her choices and create a more compelling result for the larger external conflicts that she's facing, and additionally more interesting character moments for her to live in. 3. Michelle drives her choices. Whether big or small, Michelle pushes her motivations and choices to their fullest, and it helps make the characters more compelling, but also pushes the stories those characters tell forward in a more deliberate way. 4. Michelle owns the little moments. While the big, impactful moments are often the more memorable ones, Michelle takes the small moments and really showcases how they add to the character. This work makes the characters more interesting and keeps them at the center of the story every time. 5. Michelle challenges herself. The roles Michelle has taken are diverse and challenging, resulting in her not only showing great range, but also pushing that range further. These choices grant her longevity and allow her career to go forward with new and exciting roles well beyond what is expected. Michelle Pfeiffer has been killing it for decades, and it's clear why now. She's talented, motivated, and she's been pushing herself to be better than she was in her previous performances over and over again. And I have to say that I'm incredibly glad that she was a suggestion that I took. I discovered a host of phenomenal performances that I'd never seen before, and so now I want to help you see them too. These are my 5 essential Michelle Pfeiffer performances. 1. Scarface. This classic movie about the rise and fall of a criminal empire features Michelle in a small but vital role. Her biting relationship with Al Pacino builds the movie's tension up in a small but necessary way to show the eventual tragic end of the entire thing. 2. Dangerous Liaisons. This period drama shows powerful and complex emotions and even more complex relationships. Michelle plays the most conflicted of all the characters and ultimately finds herself being torn apart by her own internal struggle far more than anyone else's influence. 3. Batman Returns. There are many iconic portrayals of famous characters, but Michelle's turn as Catwoman is one of them that stands out. She uses her charisma and intensity to push the role to extreme places and has fun while doing so. 4. Married to the Mob. This one-part witness protection thriller, one-part comedic police caper shows Michelle playing a really compelling and deep character in a story that is wild and over the top, but also heartfelt in surprising ways. 5. The Fabulous Baker Boys. Combining with brothers Jeff and Beau Bridges, Michelle sings, swoons, and ultimately sells this movie of struggling musicians and jaded people looking for breaks in all aspects of their lives. And that is why Michelle Pfeiffer is a tough act to follow. Thank you everyone for watching, and thanks again to Natalie for suggesting Michelle Pfeiffer. Which movies of Michelle's are your favorites, and which other actors do you think are well worth my time checking out and giving a look at? Let me know in the comments down below. And if you like this video, please give it a like. If you do, I will be sure to help you look good in your growing business empire. And check me out on Patreon for even more content and exclusive early access for all these videos. And to ensure you never miss another episode of A Tough Act to Follow, One to Watch, Welcome to the Party Pal, or Complex Casting, be sure to subscribe. Thanks again for watching, and as I always say, thanks for taking the time to get Ploominated.